Congratulations, ladies. First time you've played a tournament together. You win a Grand Slam. What has been the key for your success these 2 weeks?
I mean, for us, was just like having fun on the court, like Sui always been saying. I think, yeah, we were not like thinking too much about winning or losing. We were just like really enjoying each other's company on court, and they really enjoyed like playing with each other. And yeah, so happy that we made it.
Shay Sui Wei, how did you turn that match around after losing the first set 6-1?
You know, you just need to keep playing again, and you know, sometimes you lose first set, but second set, if you stay there, it's all the opportunities, sometimes they will come. You just need to keep trying. And then we was keep trying, we do some good shot, and then we cheering out each other. So I know anything can happen. Maybe we're going to lose the match today. The second set was very tough. But for me, I just keep trying and stay calm, and I was very peaceful. And I was telling her, it's okay. The worst thing is we just take the trophy with a plate.
She's like, at least we've got a plate.
Yeah.
Don't worry.
Yeah. So I told her, oh, smiley, it's okay, let's play. Yeah.
Wang Xinyu, you had that long game in the third set, the 3-1 game on your serve. That was maybe the key to that third set. If they break, it's a lot obviously tighter. Yeah. What do you think was the importance of that game to hold your serve, and how important that was?
Well, I mean, like you said, it was 3-1, and if I didn't hold my serve, it's going to be, you know, 3-2, and they're serving. And they were serving, like, pretty good, both of them today. So I think that game was really important, that I'm really, like, happy we hold that game. Otherwise, I think it could have been tighter, and yeah.
And then just, you've been so good on the baseline, Wang Xinyu, just like holding, I don't know, overpowering a lot of the baseline rallies, not just today, but in the semifinals as well. How much more comfortable have you gotten, not just on clay as a surface, but just on the doubles court as well, knowing how to use your game and your powerful game to great effectiveness here?
I mean, from the very beginning, Sue has been telling me, like, just to go aggressive and just to, like, slap the balls. And then she's like, I will go, like not this one, then next one I will go. Like, you just keep, like, being aggressive. And for me, that's, like, really, I start to realize, I start to see, like, when we go baseline and all the like good players, they cannot really hold with me, and that for me is like, I mean, it's really great, like, for the confidence. Yeah.
And then Shay Sui Wei, what does this mean for you to play your first slam since US Open 2021 and to walk away with the title?
You know, it's important to find a young girl, then you feel fresh and young. Now I feel I'm very young.
Does this one feel any different or any more special, given you've been away, 18 months?
Yeah, it's very special because I was not expecting to play, and don't know who I play with, because you know, at this time on the clay court season, it's the middle of the year or something like this. It's hard to find a partner, and I just talking with Sai Sai, and then I got a partner like this, and then we was trying to fix the game and play together and have fun. Mostly when I come back the few tournament, I was try to just enjoy it. So I'm happy that Xinyu also enjoy it, and I was enjoy it, and we play some good tennis, we help each other and smiling on the court.
Congratulations to you both. So can you tell us about the injury that you had, and whether you thought you would make it back to playing on such a fabulous stage?
Sorry, who you
asked? The time away from tennis, the injury break. What was the break that you spent away from the tour?
Oh, you asked me?
Yes.
我没有 break 过。
Sorry.
Yeah, I was injured 2019, and it affected me in the singles. But you know, I was keep playing, and I still winning some match. And one of the tournament, I was not feeling the pain. But after that couple of months, I was in the big pain, and it going worse and worse. So I decided to stop after one of the tournaments. So I told my partner at the championship, I said I cannot, I will not. In the press, I say I will not play a tournament after this. So I decided to stop because I was thinking I still want to play singles. I don't want to retire with a big injury or something. So I decided to stop a little bit. And this year, Barbara was asking me to come back together. I said, oh, that would be fun. So I come back.
Thank you.
首先恭喜两位姑娘，在获胜的一刻的时候，你们都显，我们都很激动，你们显得还蛮平静的。毕竟舒薇赢过五次，她很有经验。对，但是心瑜是第一次，为什么你也那么平静呢？你是来自于你的个性吗？能不能你们两个人描述一下你们夺冠那一刻的感受？
我感觉那一刻因为还在那个比赛里面，就其实因为我觉得到最后其实我们都还是蛮激烈的，所以就没有太反应过来，就是不会说突然一下就哇就这样子，就是还是
会。对不起，我那个球压得不够重，所以他还在移动，
他还在
追，搞得我们好像还不知道有没有要赢，有没有要赢。
对，我在等他会不会救过来。
没有，我还在，他在跑，他在跑了。
然后我也想问问星宇，我不知道我看的对不对啊，如果看的不对你纠正我。就是第一盘感觉你失误还是偏多一点点，然后从第二盘抢七打到第三盘就像打疯了一样，失误好像都没有了。你是怎么调整自己打得越来越好的？
因为一开始上来的时候，因为对手在往前给的压力会比较大嘛，然后因为他们两个左手的发球也都很好，之后自己就总觉得在场上可以打的目标变得很小，就是我只能打那一点点。然后就在第二盘，反正突然有一分，我就跟他说，我说哦，打直线你准备，然后打过去，
我终于要打直线了。
对，然后
内心都流泪了。
因为之前一直不确定说我要不要打直线，就你知道那种，然后后来一打，然后对手就没反应过来，然后从那一刻开始就觉得哇，我的场地变得好大，就是我哪里都可以打。对，就这样。
因为他球很强嘛，我想说要不要跟他讲打直线，因为那个人一直往中间晃，我想说算了，还是让他自己想打什么就打什么好了。但他说他打直线，我就是我的内心
终于开窍了。
不要啦，他那个自己会打，那他自己去打呗，他自己开心就好了，没所谓。
不然他让我打直线，然后打直线失误了，我就问他你干嘛让我打直线。
所以还是让他自己发挥。
那其实第二盘的时候王馨予还是有一些失误在身上，然后我在场边看到那个谢淑薇一直搂着王馨予的肩膀，当时有给他哪一些鼓励的话吗？
没有，我只想要让他多笑笑嘛，多笑笑就开心，开心就可以打好球了。所以我觉得没所谓，两个人尽力去打，因为本来比赛就是会有输有赢啊，然后可能有时候打不好啊，可能我今天头发没绑好，哎呀今天妨碍到我了，我有点失去了那个专注力，都会影响到比赛的嘛，因为你也不知道你的搭档有时候会有什么问题。那我觉得我也有打不好的时候啊，他也没有对我怎么样，所以我觉得大家就是互相支持啊，没有关系。那如果状态一上来的时候，我知道我们就在往好的方向走了嘛。
想问一下馨宇，因为你是第一次拿到这个大满贯的冠军，就是你拿到那个奖杯之后，当时第一个感受是什么？这个感受跟你之前想过捧杯的感觉是一样的吗？
很沉，我们两个人感觉举起来都差点举不起来。
我在那举的时候说：“赶快过来救我，好重啊！”
对，但是对，就是像它的重量一样，我觉得它对于我来说也是一个。怎么说，就是我们两个这两周打开心网球的一个结果。对。
然后我想问一下，接下来草地赛季还会继续配和舒薇配双打吗？你们
草地赛是暂时不会，因为已经跟芭芭拉讲好了。
OK。
对，因为这站原本是以为芭芭拉也是要来打，然后后来他就说他在北网退休，所以我们就说那就打温布顿这样子。然后这站我那时候想说哦，到底要不要打，因为我爸当时一听到我要签双打的时候，他觉得很无言。然后我就我想说我住在家里面，我还是摸一下球好了。等我跟他后来我跟他说这样，所以后面我们有机会再配呗。
没问题，
你先去打打针打一下。
我先去跑一跑先。
然后星宇前两天说了一个感悟，就是说在泥地上也要打出攻击性，而不是说尽管自己越来越全面，用到全面性。我想说这个冠军对你来说是不是从打法上也是一个确认，就是说我的 game 是可以的，任何场地我都可以打，有没有给你这种确认感和安全感？
对，会有。当然我觉得也是因为舒伟一直在往前帮我，给他们压力，所以说可能也是因为那个，所以我感觉跟别人打底线都对得特别的顺，然后也会有这个原因。当然自己对自己的感觉来说也是，就觉得就那个球越打越大，就是不会失误的那种感觉。
那因为你打得好，我们就会去查更多你的资料嘛。那么你现在单打排名在80左右，你的最高排名是59，那我们就会觉得啊，不可能啊，你肯定比这个好啊。Yeah.
谢谢。
就是说双打这个大满贯冠军对你的单打的职业生涯会有什么鼓励和帮助，能不能谈一谈？
我觉得还是给自己的，就是要坚持去打自己的风格，然后排名那些其实我自己不太关注，因为我觉得就是在前五十之前，就是没有进到前五十，其实你排多少都差不多。对，我觉得是这样的，就是也不会说，而且也不是说你这段时间排得高了就一下你是一个更好的球员。我觉得很多都是有很多机缘啊，机缘巧合因素在里面。当然如果你知道自己在一个对的路上，我觉得那样就够了。
那我也想请问苏威一下，因为很多球迷都很兴奋，就是说你们打法特别的互补，但是你觉不觉得你们的个性其实也是很互补的？因为你这么外向、热烈、有趣，然后你的搭档是比较会思索、比较沉静的。
你
觉得这
搭档比较无聊？
你确定我搭档没有被我弄疯吗？
哦，真的吗？那你来暴露一下他这一面，我们看不到他这一面。
哎、我的搭档好吵啊！
不让你安静啊！每天一天到晚在讲话。
没有，我说你会不会觉得我很吵啊、很疯啊？
不会。
我觉得挺好的啊，我们在球场上就是很开心，然后我不会给对方压力，然后我们就尽量打，挺好的。嗯
，OK。One more question。那我想，其实从开赛到现在，一直感觉两位就是在双打比赛这种状态很轻松，觉得就是开心就好。能不能说，感觉大家其实是在 play 在玩一样的心态来，抱着这种心态来参加职业法网，然后顺便拿了个冠军，这样的说法贴切吗？
顺便拿了一个冠军。
好了，拿冠军是出乎意料，那他也不要说顺便嘛，我们还是很努力，我们每天都很努力在练球，然后有吃很多的美食，都有帮助。对，嗯，就我们还是有很努力的，大家不要这样子。虽然我们也有在玩，
就像
我有在玩了，
你住在旁边，然后顺便来玩。
哦，有一天我们有叫他们来家里面吃冰淇淋，也买了很多很多的冰淇淋，说哎，来我们家吃个冰淇淋吧。
对
，Thank you。
谢谢，
谢谢。好，这个波多好哦，那我们坐着吗？
好，我们坐着。
耶，
我给你坐着。
耶。
好，谢谢。
Thank you。
让我也不去仔细。
很沉，很重，非常的重。嗯，真材实料哦。
真材实料，
拜拜。